Good morning. Today is the last day of the Passion Week that we've been observing. I'm grateful that you've joined us. It is, after all, Easter Sunday, and God bless you and welcome to this day of celebration all across the Christian world. We call this day rejoicing in the power of His resurrection. The women who loved Jesus came early on that Sunday morning to anoint His body, since that was forbidden on the Sabbath, and they would not risk going Saturday evening after the Sabbath concluded, for it would have been dark and even dangerous for them to go there alone. The disciples had retreated to the upper room for solace and safety, and in their sorrow, disappointment, and fear, they remained behind. Besides, attending to the body of the deceased was women's work. All four Gospels report different aspects of the reality of the empty tomb, but they all reported it. And the rejoicing that followed when the disciples realized why the tomb was empty was evident. Inspired by the Holy Spirit, each author shared a different perspective on the events that followed. Like facets of a gemstone, each one turns it and gives us a different point of view of how the discovery was made, how it was declared, and how it was comprehended. In all four accounts, Mary Magdalene was a primary participant. John assigns that wonderful discovery to Mary in describing how her confusion at the tomb was overwhelmed by the joy of discovering her living Lord. Now, on the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene came early to the tomb while it was still dark and saw the stone already taken away from the tomb. So she ran and came to Simon Peter and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved, and said to them, "They have taken away the Lord out of the tomb, and we do not know where they have laid him." John continues, "Jesus said to her, 'Woman, why are you weeping? Whom are you seeking?' Supposing him to be the gardener, she said to him, 'Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have laid him, and I will take him away.' Jesus said to her, 'Mary.' She turned and said to him in Hebrew, 'Rabboni,' which means teacher." I trust God has blessed you in this Holy Week, and you have taken time to reflect on the events that led up to the crucifixion, the burial, and the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. As terrible as the crucifixion was, without the cross, there could be no sacrifice, and without a sacrifice, there could be no pardon for sin. And without the Good Friday sacrifice of Jesus, there could not be an Easter Sunday celebration and the joy of that wonderful discovery. Though in his humanity, Jesus struggled with the ordeal of his crucifixion and all that went with it, remember he prayed, "If it be thy will, let this cup pass from me." Jesus still accepted God's way of building the bridge of reconciliation between him and a lost humanity. The same is true for us. Without accepting the harsh reality of Jesus' crucifixion, we cannot share in the hope of his resurrection. The old hymn declares it so beautifully, "I must needs go home by the way of the cross. There's no other way but this. I shall ne'er get sight of the gates of light if the way of the cross I miss. The way of the cross leads home. The way of the cross leads home. It is sweet to know as I onward go, the way of the cross leads home." Paul prayed in his letter to the Philippians, "that I may know Christ and the power of his resurrection in the fellowship of his suffering." As you have shared these daily remembrances with me, I hope one thing has come home to you, and that is that Jesus Christ is alive today, our living, reigning Lord. And he ever liveth, as Paul says in Hebrews, to make intercession for us. May you experience the power and the joy of His resurrection in your own life. For whatever you may be going through, if you have questions, He has answers. If you have needs, He's sufficient. If you are hurting, He is the great physician. God bless you, and happy Easter. He is real.